Again to the second day of our sustainability conference. The speaker of this session is Elvin De Wolf. Hi, Elvin.
Hi, Daria.
Hello. Elvin joins us from the Netherlands today, and Elvin is going to talk about carbon footprint reduction in the automotive OEM. With saying that, I would like also to remind you, ask your questions in the Q&A chat that is there on the right-hand side of your screen. Well, Elvin, the stage is yours.
Thank you, Daria, for this introduction, and thank you to everybody to join this session. In this presentation, I would like to demonstrate to you how the carbon footprint can be reduced of automotive coatings by implementing the Allnex low-bake coating system. Before we are going to discuss the Allnex solutions for OEM low bake, I would first like to go back to something which was also discussed yesterday, and that is the type of emissions which are defined in the greenhouse gas protocol for different companies. So there are scope 1, scope 2, and scope 3 emissions. And now we can discuss them in the context of automotive OEM low bake. So scope 1 emissions are emissions which are directly controlled by an organization relating to the energy they may produce themselves. So examples for scope 1 emission can, for example, be emissions from an in-house boiler. Some companies may generate their own electricity, and these are all examples of scope 1 emission. Scope 2 emissions also relate to energy, but then the purchased energy companies and organizations may use for their processes. So that would be purchased electricity, steam, heating, cooling, etc. Scope 3 emissions are also indirect emissions like scope 2 emissions. And in principle, scope 3 emissions are all the other emissions related to a process from a company. So this could be transportation of goods, it could be the travel emissions from employees, but also the disposal of waste and the production and purchase of raw materials. If we would consider automotive OEM low bake, then it relates to the energy consumed by the paint ovens. Assuming that the ovens are nowadays electrical ovens, and also assuming that car manufacturers may not generate their own electricity, that means that the implementation of low bake in automotive OEM would reduce the scope 2 emissions of car manufacturers. So I think that it's generally known that the paint shop in car production sites is one of the parts which consumes a significant part of the energy of car manufacturing. And in the paint shop, it is the paint ovens which also consume a significant part of the total energy in the paint shop. It has been demonstrated before that implementation of a low-bake system can result in 15 to 20% of energy saving compared to a standard automotive OEM process, where the standard process involves baking at 140 degrees and the low-bake would bring that baking temperature back to 80 degrees. So this is a significant energy saving part, and that of course can result in a significant reduction of the CO2 emissions and therefore have a sustainability advantage. Of course, with the current high energy prices, it would not only be a sustainability advantage, but also a significant cost saving to reduce the energy consumed during the painting. So there is also an economic advantage involved with implementation of low bake in automotive OEM. Furthermore, everybody knows that in the standard system, the plastic parts on the car are usually baked at 80 degrees, and traditionally the metal car body is baked at 140 degrees. So that means that the metal and the plastic parts need to be baked separately. If we would go to a low bake system, that would also simplify the complete process from a logistical point of view, but because it would enable simultaneous baking of the plastic and metal parts. So there are several advantages involved by moving to a low bake system. So Alnex has been working on solutions for automotive OEM low bake, and these solutions involve all three layers of a typical car coating. So first, for the waterborne primer surfacer, Alnex is offering waterborne acrylic resins from the Marc Rinal range. For a waterborne low bake base coat, we offer POD resins from our Daotan range, which can be cross-linked by a Simel resin. And for the solvent-borne two components clear coat, we offer solvent-borne acrylic and polyester resins from the Cetalux and Cetal ranges. More in detail, for an automotive low bake waterborne 2K primer surfacer, we would recommend to use Marc Rinal SM6826, which is a hydroxyfunctional acrylate dispersion with a broad application window, and it also provides very fast drying. You can see the paint formulation we recommend on the right hand side of this slide. And the performance of this formulation in a low bake environment is further fine-tuned by the use of our Aditol additives. Similarly, for the waterborne low bake 1K base coat, we would recommend to use our POD resin, Daotan TW7061, which is also our new all-round POD resin for waterborne base coat in automotive. It is solvent and emulsifier free. It also has a very broad application window and does not provide any yellowing. It has a big advantage that it can be used in interior and exterior application. And again, you can see our guiding formulation on the right-hand side of this slide, where you see the Daotan TW7061 on the, as the first ingredient. You can also see that to boost some mainly mechanical properties, the base coat can be a little cross-linked using Simel 327. And also here, the performance of the waterborne base coat was further fine-tuned, especially for low-bake applications, by using our Aditol additives. Finally, for the solvent-borne 2K clear coat, we also developed a few resins, especially for low-bake application. And here we recommend to use a mixture of Cetalux 1232 and Cetal 1624, which are a fast-drying acrylic polyol and a high-solid polyester polyol. Both are designed to provide excellent chemical resistance, and I will come back to this property later in this presentation. And again, on the right-hand side, you can see the guiding formulation we recommend for a low-bake solvent-borne clear coat in automotive OEM. And of course, as always in OEM, you would like to have a very robust balance between sagging and appearance. In standard high-bake applications, of course, Alnex is offering here opaque SCA resins. And these SCA resins are well-known in the market and perform very well at high-bake applications. However, these opaque SCA resins in low-bake applications can leave a slight haze. And that is why for automotive low-bake applications, we would recommend strong SCA resins. And for this purpose, we developed especially Cetalux 61230, which is such a strong SCA modified resin, which will also give excellent sag control and a good balance between the sag control and the appearance. And it will also give a very high brilliance in low bake applications. So these are the three layers we developed for, especially for automotive OEM low bake. And the next thing we did is, of course, apply the complete low bake system as described by these three guiding formulations. So that would first start with a low bake waterborne 2K primer surfacer. We would apply it typically at a layer thickness between 30 and 35 microns. And then after a 5 minute flash off, we would bake it at 30 minutes at 80 degrees. Then of course the next layer would be applied, which is the low bake base coat, as I shown before. And that would typically be done at a dry layer thickness of 20 to 25 microns. And after a short flash off, we would give it a further curing at 80 degrees for 10 minutes. And then the coating would be finished with the solvent-borne 2K clay coat for low bake. That would typically have a layer thickness between 50 and 55 microns, given a 10-minute flash off, and then we would cure it at 30 minutes at 80 degrees. So in the comparative results I'm going to show you in the next slides, we did tests on this system, so this three-layer system. And we did also a comparison where we replaced the low bake clear coat by a commercially available high bake clear coat. And of course, the high bake clear coat as reference was also baked at 140 degrees. So in the next slides, you will see the comparison between the low bake clear coat system, full system baked at 80 degrees, and also the similar system, but then with a high bake clear coat baked at 140 degrees. Let's first do the comparison for appearance and sagging. Of course, the sagging with our SCA resins can be tuned. So we tuned the sagging of the low bake system in such a way that it had similar sag resistance compared to the high bake clear coat. And given this similar sag resistance, we found that the appearance of the Alnex low bake system was significantly better compared to the system with the high bake clear coat reference. So we had lower values for low for long wave and short wave, higher values for DOI and gloss. Before we started the development of OEM low bake coating layers, chemical resistance was identified as potentially one of the more critical performance parameters. So we are very proud that we achieved in the end similar chemical resistance compared to the system with a high bake clear coat reference. And we think this was in the end quite special. So similar chemical resistance was achieved on par with the high bake reference for gradient oven tests. So that would be typically the sulfuric acid, pancreatine, water resistance, sodium hydroxide, and tree resin. So they were all on par with the high bake clear coat reference. But also the xylene resistance was on a similar level as we obtained with the high bake clear coat reference. And it was, I think, already quite special that after 1 hour, similar xylene resistance for low bake was observed compared to the high bake reference. And I think that the contribution from, as I mentioned, the Cetalux 1232 and the Cetal 1624, especially designed to give good chemical resistance, I think that this really helped in achieving this result. Since the chemical resistance is so good for this system, we did not think it was really a problem that the hardness of the low bake system was slightly lower compared to the high bake clear coat reference. The hardness was still on a very good level, but well, of course, with a high bake clear coat reference, the hardness obtained was a little bit higher. Talking about wear and tear of a coating, we also tested the stone chip resistance before and after the PV1200 test. And here we found that the Alnex full low bake system performed significantly better compared to high bake clear coat reference. So this is also another property where the performance of our system was particularly very good. Finally, we also paid attention to water resistance, humidity resistance, and QCT condensation tests. And I think also here we had very positive results of the Allnex low bake system compared to high bake clear coat reference system. So we did not see any blistering or whitening with the Allnex low bake system. We had, as mentioned also in the section with the appearance, we had excellent gloss, not only before the water exposure, but also after exposure. The same is true for the haze. So we had a very low starting haze, also thanks to the strong SCA we used in this formulation. And also after exposure, there was not a significant increase of the haze of this system. The flexibility of the system was very good. And I think that, for an acceptable coating system, of course, the adhesion needs to be excellent. And that was also the case with the coating layers of the Allnex low bake system. So I think that the main performance of the Allnex low bake coating system was very good, and in many cases better compared to a high bake clear coat reference. So that is summarized on this slide. So I explained that the appearance of the Allnex low bake system was better compared to a high bake reference. The hardness of the low bake system was on a very good level. The stone chip resistance was better, the QCT and humidity resistance was better, and the chemical resistance, to our surprise, and also thanks to the design of the 1232 and the Cetal 1624, the chemical resistance was also on par with the high bake clear coat reference. So overall, we would say that the Allnex low bake system would perform better compared to the system with the high bake clear coat reference. Summarizing the low bake section of this presentation, and also explaining why paint formulators are advised to switch to low bake systems. Well, of course, there is a sustainability advantage. So compared to a standard OEM process with high bake baking steps for primer and clear coat, a 15 to 20% reduction of the CO2 emissions can be achieved if low bake is implemented. This is, of course, not only a sustainability advantage, but it will, with the high energy prices of this time, it will also give economic advantages. Furthermore, there will be a simplification of the logistics of the baking system if the low bake system is implemented, because the metal car body and the plastic parts can be baked simultaneously. Furthermore, we believe that the Allnex low bake system, typically as mentioned, baked at 80 degrees, might also be interesting, especially the technology itself, for applications outside the automotive OEM market, because 80 degrees curing is acceptable in other markets as well. So that might, for example, be industrial metal stoving applications, wheel coatings, and maybe other applications as well. We have not yet explored this technology in these applications, but it's something which is in our pipeline to do. I think that this concludes the low bake part of this presentation, and I think that paint developers for automotive OEM also know that apart from low bake, there are other sustainable in the industry trends as well. And in the last few slides of this presentation, I would like to briefly touch upon the other sustainability trends in automotive OEM and explain to you which products Allnex is offering here. So another sustainable trend in automotive OEM is going more and more towards low VOC options. Of course, it's obvious that lower VOC will also result in a lower carbon footprint, and therefore will also give a significant sustainability advantage. low VOC can be achieved in different ways. So if we are talking about solvent-borne system, of course, we would like to move to high solid systems. And if we are talking about high solid automotive OEM clear coats, for example, then Allnex is offering Citalux 97099, which is a high solid SCA resin, which can yield a significant VOC reduction of clear coats formulated with this SCA resin. If we are talking about waterborne systems, then of course we are looking for automotive or to waterborne base coats, for example. And here also Allnex is offering several products. So on the one hand, we offer Cetaqua 6809, which is a high solid PAD resin for waterborne base coat. And with this resin, it is possible to achieve increased flop indexes. So that's something everybody wants in waterborne base coat. And that's accompanied with a low VOC and also a high solid. So that's the special feature of this this new resin in our portfolio. Also for our PUD portfolio, the Daotan range, we are developing high solid PUD resins, and this is still in development, and products will come out of this development shortly. Another sustainability trend in automotive OEM, which is getting quite a bit of attention at the moment, is OFLA. OFLA is the state-of-the-art overspray-free paint application, and the sustainability advantages here are on the one hand less waste, so that is of course the less overspray which is accompanied with this way of application, but especially a lot of energy can be saved because the ventilation which is needed for spray applications can for OFLA be significantly reduced. Also for OFLA, Allnex is offering and also developing different products. So if we are talking about OFLA waterborne base coats, Allnex is offering Daotan and Cetaqua resins with special rheology. And these resins are ready to test in OFLA waterborne base coat applications. For OFLA solvent-borne applications, there are still quite some challenges, especially if we're talking about vertical application. And here, Allnex believes that SCA will still be a vital component to solve the issue of sagging and appearance also in OFLA applications. And this is also something we are working on at the moment. Here we are also hopeful for good results in the near future. A final trend, of course, is three-coat one bake. Well, three-coat one bake in itself is not a new trend. It might be already ongoing for maybe 20 or more years. And up until now, three-coat one bake, looking at the clear coat, mostly uses two-component clear coats. And two-component clear coats are known for their good chemical resistance and also for their very good appearance. However, in many markets, paint formulators also believe that one component clear coat formulations have definitely certain benefits. For example, they are isocyanate free. Also with the melamine resins currently providing, they are also very low or even free of formaldehyde. One component clear coats are often considered to be more economical. There are shortages of isocyanate supply in the market at the moment. And also because there is nearly no reactivity at room temperature, the one component clear coats offer a greater process freedom. So one component clear coat would definitely have advantages also in three coat one bake. And for this purpose, novel one component clear coat formulations have been developed, which rival the appearance of two component formulations in three coat one bake. And for this purpose, Allnex developed Cetalux 1928, which is an, let's say, ultra high solid acrylate polyol. And we also developed its SCA modified resin, Cetalux 9 1928, And the combination of these resins will provide excellent performance in 3-coat, 1-bake, 1K clear coat. And then also for 1K clear coat, you can have the sustainable benefit that a primer layer can be omitted. Also a baking step involved with the primer layer can be omitted, and less material is needed. So that means that in the end, this is the big sustainability advantage related to 3-coat 1-bake. So this was the final part of my application, and I would like to hand back to Daria for the Q&A session.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Elvin, for this interesting presentation. And now, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you.
Okay, very good. And now we go to the questions, and we could already collect some. Well, Elvin, we got the question about the use of 3 ovens at 80 degrees. So the question is following. Most energy efficient OEMs now use 1 oven for the full system, for the compact processes. So are we able to save energy with the proposal that you mentioned?
This is a very interesting question. Thank you. I think that in the presentation, I touched upon several trends regarding sustainability in automotive OEM. So low bake is one trend. And on the final slide, I also mentioned 3-coat 1-bake as another trend. And of course, both have their sustainability advantage, as indicated by the person who asked the question and also indicated during the presentation. Of course, it makes sense to combine these different trends in the automotive OEM market. And then in the end, the next step would, of course, be a 3-coat 1-bake low bake system. So we think that also with our technology, this is feasible. So that means that we now did the test system with 3 baking steps. But in the end, I think it would also be possible to do to achieve similar results with just 1 baking step. So that would be a next step in our investigations.
Thank you for answering this question, Elvin. And we go to the next. Are there blends of waterborne and solventborne formulas that would enhance hardness for OEM?
If it would be blends of waterborne and solventborne resins in one paint, I think that might result in maybe stability issues. I think I need a little bit more background for the exact purpose why the person is asking this question. Of course, it's always there are solvent-borne resins which can be just like solvents which can be mixed into waterborne systems. So, of course, waterborne systems can take up a certain amount of solvent-borne material. So that's not something we have looked at the moment in this case.
Thank you so much for taking this one. And we move to the next. With biofeedstock or recycled materials, I'm sorry, will biofeedstock or recycled materials be part of the sustainable approach for Alnex in low bake?
So I started my presentation by explaining scope 1, scope 2, and scope 3 emissions. And I explained that the low bake, as we presented it now, mainly reduces the scope 2 emissions. Of course, it is interesting to also look at scope 3 emissions. So that would involve the bio-based and recycled materials. So the resins we developed at the moment, as I mentioned also with the previous question, let's go step by step, because each step requires its special attention. So now we are offering technology for low bake. And of course, a next step would also be to bake the resins itself. we are now offering for Lobeck to make the resins with regard to the raw materials more sustainable as well. And that would involve the reduction of the scope 3 emissions for the car manufacturer. So I think in the next years, of course, Alnex is working on it. So it's something we will definitely develop. I think that in the next years, also with the increasing market demand, developments will go very fast. So bio-based and recycled feedstock will definitely have attention in automotive OEM, as it has in any of the markets we are supplying resins for. So yes, it will come.
Thank you, Elvin, very much. And we continue with questions. How is your technology performing in scratch resistance testing? We noticed that the scratch resistant was not mentioned by you as one of the properties.
Yeah. So scratch resistance was not taken along in this particular study. For scratch resistance, we do have an additive ModaFlow NSR100. This is especially for the automotive application, is an additive for scratch resistance. We know that this additive works in the automotive low bake OEM clear coat. So it can easily be incorporated, it was not included in this study because this is quite a recent result. But we know that this additive works, and if paint formulators would like to improve the scratch resistance of this low bake clear coat, we advise them to use ModaFlow NSR100.
Thank you, Elvin. And we move forward. Questions to the clear coat. What is the thermal latent hardener for clear coat?
Yeah. I think that in the market there are only a very few thermal latent hardener commercially available. This is also the one we used in these studies. Of course, we did tests and combined it with several of our resins and noticed that the performance of the thermolatent hardener is maybe not always as good as one might hope. But we found and also tuned the CETAL 1624 and CETALUX 1232 to perform particularly well with this thermolatent hardener. I think that's the combination of this hardener with our optimized resins is giving these special chemical resistance as explained in this presentation.
Thank you, Elvin, for answering this one. And we move to the next. Can coil coatings be done at low bake temperature for OEM?
Ooh, that's an interesting one. Mm-hmm. My true answer is I don't know. We focused on in this study on the complete automotive OEM system, so that would be primer, base coat, clear coat, and studied if the performance of this system would be similar if we would have a similar system with a high bake clear coat reference. I think that the suggestion is very interesting and definitely worth further investigation.
Thank you, Elvin, for taking this one too. And we move to the next. As you mentioned, Elvin, the auto component market is currently curing plastic parts at 80 degrees. Are you working to reduce the cure temperature for plastic parts below 80 degrees? Thank you.
We do have technology to also lower the baking temperature of plastic coatings. I would suggest that maybe we should use or advise different technology for a lower baking plastic coating. I would advise the person who asked this question to contact the regular Alnex contact person and ask for our fast cure technology. That will provide plastic coatings which can be cured at 60 or maybe even lower temperatures, also in plastics.
Thank you very much. We are running out of time, but I would like still to ask you a couple of questions.
Yeah.
About the pot life, Elvin. Can you please comment on the port life for water-based 1K base code formulations?
I think, there is pot life and shelf life. And at a certain point, pot life runs into shelf life if we are talking about days or weeks. I think that it's quite common to add a melamine hardener to waterborne base coats. If you may have noticed, the amount of melamine hardener we added was very small. So I think that it should be all right.
Thank you for covering this one too. For the base coat, how much does the Cymal 327 react at the low bake conditions?
I think that the Cymal 327 is a resin which was also designed to be highly reactive. It could also already react under certain conditions at room temperature. Of course, we didn't test, but we did do tests in the full low-bake system with and without this Cymal hardener, and found better performance with the Cymal hardener. So that's why we think that it definitely contributes to the performance of the total system.
Thank you. And the very last question for this session, I apologize, everyone, we just need to run to the next one. I would like to ask following. The solution you presented refers to scope 2 emissions. Do you have any ideas on how to reduce the carbon footprints of your binders in the scope 3?
Yes, well, that also relates a little bit to an earlier question regarding bio-based and recycled feedstock. As I mentioned, I think we are now in a stage where we take different sustainability technologies step by step. But in the end, of course, we would need to combine them. With all the possibilities we can reduce the carbon footprint of our resins themselves, as also mentioned in the previous sessions of this conference today and yesterday, this is also something we can implement in this technology as well, and in that way still further reduce the carbon footprint of the total OEM system. So there is definitely a long way to go. Low bake can be a first step, which may be easy to implement. There is more coming from Alnex. So I'm very excited to work on this.
Thank you very much, Elvin. I see there are still questions coming in the pool. Don't worry, they won't be forgotten. I will send all the questions to Elvin just after the conclusion of this session, and he's going to answer them, and we will publish them. The answers will be published on Monday next week. Well, thank you, Elvin, for your presentation. Thank you, everyone, for asking your questions, and see you in the next session in a few minutes.
Thank you.
Bye, Elvin. Bye.
Bye. Bye.